الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على دين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا به وتوحيدا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. And continuing with the five virtues that was given to this ummah in Ramadan that was not given to any other nation before it. The first we said was خُلُوفًا مِصَّائِمْ أَطْيَبُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ رِيحِ الْمِسْكِ, that the foul odor emanating from the mouth of the fasting person is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the fragrance of musk. Number two, يَسْتَغْفِرَ لَهُمَ الْمَلَائِكَ حَتَّى يُفْتِرُوا, that the angels seek forgiveness for the fasting person all the way into the moment they break their fast. Number three, and يُزَيِّنَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى كُلِّ يَوْمٍ جَنَّتَهُ وَيَقُولُ يُوشِكُ عِبَادِي الصَّالِحُونَ أَنْ يُلْقُوا عَنْهُمَ الْمَأُونَ وَالْأَذَى وَيُسِيرُ إِلَيْكَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day during the days of Ramadan, He beautifies His paradise for His servants in preparation, tahiyatan, preparation for their entry into paradise. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day from the days of Ramadan beautifies His paradise for His righteous servants. And it is said, perhaps my servants, my righteous servants, all of the pain and the anguish and the difficulties that they find in this dunya will be removed from them so they can do more deeds and enter into you. And it's not mustaqrab, it's not something amazing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to paradise or speaks to the hellfire. As we know the conversation in Surah Al-Qaf where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to the hellfire. There's a conversation and even the hellfire asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, هَلْ مِن مَزِيد, do you have any more? Do you have any more for me? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beautifies His paradise for the believers every day in the day of Ramadan, in the days of Ramadan, in preparation for the entry into paradise. Number four, تُصَفَّدُ مَرَدَّةُ الشَّيَاطِينَ فَلَا يُخْلَصُونَ إِلَى مَا كَانَ يَخْلُصُونَ إِلَيْهِ فِي غَيْرِ, that the مَرَدَّةُ الشَّيَاطِينَ, and this is a big misconception with a lot of the Muslims, they believe that all of the shayateen are chained up. All of the shayateen are not chained up in Ramadan. The narration mentioned مَرَدَّةُ الشَّيَاطِينَ أَشَدُّ الشَّيَاطِينَ عَدَاوَةً لِبْنِ آدَمَ, and these are the shayateen that have the most devious of the shayateen and the ones that have the strongest level of hatred and animosity towards the children of Adam. And that is not all of the shayateen. And as Imam Al-Qurtubi rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, وَتَصَفَّدُ تَصْفِيدُ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَا يَدُلَّ عَلَىٰ عَدَمٍ مَعَاصِي فِي رَمَضَانِ, that even though the shayateen are chained up, that does not mean that sin will not be committed in Ramadan. Because the age-old question is, well, if the shayateen are chained up in Ramadan, then how is it that the Muslims still commit sin? Imam Al-Qurtubi rahimahullah ta'ala, he said that their sin in Ramadan for reasons other than the shayateen. And he mentioned three. Number one, nufus al-khabitha, that some souls are just prone to sin. That's just their nature. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, وَلَا أُبَرِّئُ نَفْسِي إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي, as it was mentioned in the ayats last night in Surah Yusuf, that I don't free myself from blame. Indeed, the soul, أَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ, it naturally inclines toward, there are some souls that naturally incline towards sin. النفوس الخبيثة, they're just prone to sin. He said in number two, الجن أو الشياطين الإنسية, is that we also have the jinn from amongst mankind. So the jinn that take on human form is still amongst us. And that whisper that we get from those bad companions that encourage us to do wrong. And he mentioned number three, العادات القبيحة, is that some of the bad habits that we bring with us from outside of Ramadan into Ramadan. We're creatures of habit as human beings. And it's far-fetched to believe that you تعتاد في 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 عادات يعني في خارج رمضان وتتخلى منها في في داخل رمضان, that you have, you know, taken on some characteristics or some traits, or you have become prone to certain behaviors outside of Ramadan. It is far-fetched to believe that as soon as the month of Ramadan comes, you're going to leave off those characteristics or leave off that behavior. That is not going to happen. You're going to bring those things with you into Ramadan. And so these are, you know, some of the reasons. But the most devious of the shayateen are chained up. And this makes it easy for the believers, as the Prophet ﷺ said, لا يخلصون إلى ما كان يخلصون إليه في غيري. That so, therefore, the shayateen are not able to have an impact on the believers in Ramadan like they have on the believers outside of Ramadan. That the shayateen, they wage war against the children of Adam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حِيثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُ. That indeed the shaitan and his party, they watch you from an area where you cannot see them, but they see you. They see our weaknesses, they know the things that we are weak to, and they wage war against us. Shaitan made Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a promise that I will come to them from before them and behind them, in front of them and back of them, and you will find that تَجِدَ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ, and you will find that most of them are ungrateful. You will find that most of them are ungrateful. And the last is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فِي آخِرِ اللَّيْلَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive the believers in the last day. فَقَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَهِيَ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ قَالَ لَهُ لكن العامل يوفى أجره إذا قضى عمله. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the last virtue that is given to this ummah, that was not given to any other ummah that came before it, is that the fasting person will reap his reward at the last day of Ramadan. The Sahaba, confused, said, does this mean Laylatul Qadr? Are you referring to Laylatul Qadr? He said, no, I'm not referring to Laylatul Qadr. But the norm with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that when the servant is done with his deed, then he reaps his reward at the end of completion of his deed. And this reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiveness for our sins. And this is also something that is characteristic with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we seek forgiveness at the end of our deeds, right? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fi istighfar al-majlis, that after we sit down and have a conversation, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam instructed us to say, Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. That after we sit down and have a conversation with one another, before we get up and depart from one another, that we should make this dua, and in this dua asking Allah forgiveness, so any laghwi, any frivolous talk, or any talk that may have been backbiting, or anything that is displeasing to Allah, we will be forgiven for it in our gatherings. So before we finish sitting down, before we depart, we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. During Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, ثُمَّ أَفِيضُ مِنْ حَيْثُ أَفَاضَ النَّاسِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ, and then return back to Mina in the same place where everybody else returns back to, and then seek Allah's forgiveness. At the end of your Hajj, when you're finished with your deeds for Hajj, at the end you should seek Allah's forgiveness. When we are done with the Salah, when we make the Taslim to the right and the left, the first thing we say when we're done is what? Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. Oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, I beseech your forgiveness. Oh Allah, I ask you for your forgiveness. So it is a common courtesy that after we are done with our deeds, that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. Here, when we're done with our fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a complimentary gift for your fasting, extends forgiveness to you. You don't have to ask for it. It extended to you. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you at the end of Ramadan, because the deed, the person who does the deed, will reap his reward at the end of his deed when it's done. And the reward here is forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And why? This is my question to you all. Why do we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness at the end of the completion, or at the completion of our deeds? Why? What is the benefit, the fa'ida, of asking Allah's forgiveness? For example, at the end of the salah, we say astaghfirullah 3 times. What is the fa'ida? What is the benefit of asking Allah's forgiveness for our salah after we're done?
Because we make may have more shortcomings if we do it in the middle that we didn't ask for it to become forgiven.
Ahsant. The reason why we ask Allah's forgiveness at the end of the deed, at the completion of the deed, is that perhaps we had did some things or done some things during the course of the action that may have invalidated the action or may have infringed on the reward of the action. As we know, the salat, much like many other deeds, there are the reward of it is dependent on how focused you were in the salat. As the Prophet ﷺ said, يُشِكُ أَنْ يَنْصَرِفُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ صَلَاتِهِ وَلَا يُكْتَبْ لَهُ إِلَّا نِصْفُهَا أَوْ ثُلُثُهَا أَوْ رُبُعُهَا أَوْ خُمُسُهَا أَوْ سُدُسُهَا إِلَى آخِرِ. He said that it's possible that a servant will leave out of his prayer and only have written for him a reward half of it, or a third of it, or a fourth of it, or a fifth of it, or a sixth of it, or a seventh of it, eighth of it, ninth of it, or a tenth of it. If you have a tenth of salat, that means you have nothing. You have nothing. 10 of 10 is nothing. A tenth of 1 of 10 is nothing. 0 from 10 is nothing. So the rewards for the deeds is dependent on, at least with the salat, is dependent on how focused you were in the prayer. So if you were drifting off in your prayer and not really focused, then asking Allah's forgiveness at the end of the prayer will hopefully make up for any shortcomings that you had in the prayer.
Allah.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. So these are 5 virtues that was given to this ummah in Ramadan that was not given to any other nation that came before. And inshallah ta'ala, in the upcoming classes, bi'idhnillah, we'll go through the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, and then we'll pick out some of the fawaid, some of the so many benefits. As I listened last night to the story of Yusuf, and there's so many benefits. This is a story that carries so much, a treasure chest of jewels with it. And inshallah ta'ala, every halaqah inshallah will pull a different fa'ida, benefit from the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, so that we can contemplate and reflect on those things during the month of Ramadan. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam tasliman kathira wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.